Yes, so looking at the paragraph A, a bustling girl went every day to a silent torrent. Silent, since the worker's paradise, even a torrent wouldn't waste its energy singing to fill her pitchers. Okay, now, before anything, I write down the meaning of bustling. Bustling is a girl. Bustling is the word for hurrying up. And torrent is a small stream. Since it's a worker's paradise, the stream is also giving her words telling that I also can't keep quiet. I have to sing for my pitchers. Pitchers in the sense, those who come and fill their pot from the stream. So the stream is giving a message that since I also reside in this place, I will also sing for my pitchers every day. The girl's movement on the road was like the rapid movement of a skilled hand on the strings of a guitar. See how the girl is compared to the guitar strings? Moving fingers on the guitar strings. Her hair was carelessly done. Inquisitive wisp peeped often over her forehead to peer at the dark wonder of her eye. See, in this paragraph, we learn about the girl's appearance. The girl's appearance is explained in such a brief way that it tells that the girl had no time even to dress herself up. So this busy she was spending her life in worker's paradise. And now, aha, she cried with concern. You have no work in hand, have you? Now she's shocked actually. She's telling that you have no work in hand, means you have nothing to do. The man sighed, work? I've not a moment to spare for work. Look at this stupid man, how he's telling, work? I don't have 1 second also to do any work. This explains that how lazy he is. The girl did not understand his words and said, I shall spare some work for you to do if you like. So the girl is telling that if you like to do some work, I'll give you some work. The man replied, girl of the silent torrent, all this time I have been waiting to take some work from your hands. The man is telling that girl of the silent torrent. The man labeled the girl as girl of silent torrent. He's telling, I'm waiting from such long time to take some work from you. What kind of work would you like? The girl is asking the man, what kind of work do you like? Will you give me one of your pitchers? One that you can spare. So see how the man is telling her. He's trying to deviate her from her work. He's telling, give me a pot. Pitcher is a pot wherein you'll fill the water and come from the stream. So he's telling, if you have an extra pitcher, you give it to me. So now, she asked, a pitcher? You want to draw water from the torrent? Now she's confused, because if somebody asks a pot, it's understood that either you'll fill water in that or you'll do something with it. So now she's happy asking, you want to fill water? So let's see. No, I shall draw pictures on your pitcher. See how he's confusing. I will not fill water. I want to decorate it. The girl was annoyed. It's really annoying, right? When somebody offers you to help them and you tell, no, I'll not do this, I'll do that. Yes. Pictures indeed. I have no time to waste on such as you. I am going. And she walked away. This girl got angry. She's telling, I have no time to waste on you. I'm going. But how could a busy person get the better one who had nothing to do? Every day they met and every day he said to her, girl of the silent torrent, give me one of your clay pitchers. I shall draw pictures on it. What do you mean by clay pitchers? The pots which are made out of mud. And these days, in olden days, it's a ritual of old people that to drink cold water, they fill the pot with water, wrap it with a wet cloth, and they start drinking the water after some time. So here, the man every day started repeating the same old statement telling, give me one of your pitcher, I want to decorate it, give me one. So let's see what happens. But how could she yielded at last. She gave him one of her pictures. The man started painting. He drew line after line. He put color after color. See, once he gets the pot, he started decorating it. And how was the decoration? He drew lines after lines and put colors on it. One color, then the other color. When he had completed his work, the girl held up the pitcher and started and stared at its sides. Her eyes puzzled. What do you mean by her eyes puzzled? This means that it was very attractive. He finished the work and he gave the pot to her, and the girl found the pot to be really attractive. "Bros drawn," she asked. "What do they mean? All those lines and colors. What is their purpose?" Now the girl starts admiring the pot so deeply that she asked that, "What do so many lines mean, and why did you add so many colors to it?" See what the man replies. The man laughed. "Nothing. A picture may have no meaning and serve no purpose. See, we can tell this man doesn't even know what he is doing, but he does things only which gives him interest. So he's telling that what work I do have no purpose. I do it only for my interest." The girl went away with her picture. At home, away from prying eyes, she held it in the light, turned it round and round, and scanned the painting from all angles. At night, she moved out of bed, lighted a lamp, and scanned it again in silence. For the first time in her life, she had seen something that had no meaning and no purpose at all. Yes, since we learned that people in workers' paradise did very useful works, but this man, unluckily, he went into workers' paradise and he didn't do any work. So what he does, he meets this girl, he takes a pot, decorates it and gives it to her. So what the girl does is, in the night, when the pot was that attractive that she felt that something in life which is of no purpose, means which is not going to give any benefits and which has no meaning, how can it be so beautiful? What does all this mean? Now she's trying to find out, what does all this mean? When she set out for the torrent the next day, her hurrying feet were a little less hurried than before. See, the impact has begun again. For a new sense seemed to have awakened in her, a sense that seemed to have no meaning and no purpose at all. So now, this girl had a work of filling water from the stream. So every day the way she used to go to the stream was in such a way that she was always in a hurry to do something very quickly. She wanted to finish the work. But the next day, after the pot was given to her, the way she started walking and going towards the stream became slow. And she started thinking that, yes, it's not necessary to do only useful works. We can also do something which is not useful. She saw the painter standing by the torrent and asked in confusion. Now the man's turned to become a painter. Here we learn that the man has left an impression on the girl, telling that apart from all useful works, there are certain works which can be done for our interest also. I hope you understood whatever was explained till now.